So this is awesome that we have created our agent. We've given it access to an MCP server that we created from scratch. And at this stage, what you could do is move forward with doing things with code. And to do so, you're going to scroll down to the bottom on the left-hand side of the agent builder. You'll select View Code. And then from here, you'll choose your SDK of your choosing. I'm going to go with the Microsoft Agent Framework. And then your language, in this case, we currently support Python if you're using the framework. And now we actually get the code for our agent. We do have some comments at the top for how to go about running this script. So there is a dependency you'll need to install, and then you need to also save this file as well. I'll go ahead and do that for you now so you can see. Let's go to File, Save As. We are going to call this, we'll keep things simple. We'll call it Pet Planner Agent, and we'll save that. So now that's been saved as well. Make sure you have it saved where you really want it saved. Like right now, mine went to this SRC folder. I don't quite think I want it there. So I'm going to just move it to the root of that. Yep, move. Perfect. Otherwise, we'll get a little tripped up when we go to run this in a terminal. And then from here, let's take you through what's happening in this file. So we have our import statements. And then just below that, we're pulling in the endpoint. And by we, I mean the code that gets generated gets pulled in based on the Foundry project that you have set as your default. And so this is why it is very important to make sure that you set the proper default project in the extension. And so it pulled in my endpoint for me. I don't have to go figure out where that's located in the Foundry portal. I also have the model pulled in as well. So it does know I've been using that GPT 4.1 mini model. And then I have the name for my agent. I have agent instructions as well. It pulled in the instructions that we set. I could change the agent name if I wanted, just as a heads up. And then down below, we have some user inputs as well. And so these are the inputs that were from the playground or the chat when we were chatting with the agent in the agent builder. I can always swap these out for something else, and we'll do that shortly so that way we can run this so you can see what that's like. And then from there, we are getting into using the local MCP server that was created. You will need to deploy your server to wherever you prefer in the event that you are deploying this agent somewhere, because right now everything is local. We're using the default Azure credential to authenticate. There's no API keys anywhere, and that's going to be a much safer choice. In terms of security, at least. And then down below, we are processing the user messages as well. And then we're just going to run everything. So a couple things we need to do. We want to set up the environment. Let's get you set up in the environment appropriately. So I'm going to open back up that terminal. And I do see I'm already in my virtual environment. That's lovely. We've saved the file already, which is the petplanneragent.py. We're going to install this agent framework. We're going to do the pre-release version. So again, because I use UV, I'm going to do UV pip install agent-framework and then --pre. That'll install that for me. And we look to be in a good condition and position for that. Yep. All right. We look awesome. So that's been installed now. And as a reminder, keep the debugger running. Do not turn it off. If you do turn it off, you just need to restart it, but just keep that running since we're still working locally right now. So we have the dependencies in, we have the file saved. And the last thing I want to do, I mentioned the user inputs. We don't want to send all these in. If anything, you know what? I do want to send these in because we're going to get follow-up questions. So let's say that these are the follow-up question or the follow-up input to the model each time. Each time it follows up with the question from us. So with that said, I think we can actually go ahead and run this. So I'm going to do Python pet dash, ooh. I almost forgot a step. We need to authenticate. I totally missed that earlier. There's going to be one or two ways that you authenticate. They're both going to be AZ commands using the Azure CLI. And you're either going to run AZ login. Once you do that, you will get a URL and a code. You're going to enter that at the URL. You'll sign in, you'll authenticate. But if your subscription setup is a little different and more unique like mine, your URL is going to be a little different. So I'm going to enter mine in. A key difference is that one, it's going to be longer. And second, it's going to start out with the AZ login, but then you're going to pass in your tenant as well as the dash dash use device code at the very end. Pressing enter there, I'm going to get that URL that I mentioned. Everything from here should be the same, but you're going to copy that code that I mentioned earlier, and then you're going to open up that link. This will open up a page for you to enter that code. You'll select next, and then you'll sign in accordingly, and you'll just click continue to continue on. You can then close that page there. And now from there, what you'll need to do is select your subscription. So I know mine happens to be the first one. And now we're all set. I'm just going to clear that out for you all. Now we can move forward with testing this out. I'm going to run Python pet-planner-agent.py. And if all works appropriately, we are going to be able to see output from this agent, and it's going to be using our tools. All right, so we have the first user input has been submitted. And I do get the general sort of response back asking for more information about the poodle. And so then I say he's 2 and so on and so forth. And it asks me another follow-up, and I just say that he likes playing tug. So in this case, it seems like based on the way this conversation unfolded, I didn't get a chance to get any of the tools called. We'll see if we can get any tools called. Let's check just to be on the safe side. So let's cheat this a little bit, just given the way that this is run. We don't have it so that way we can go back and forth and have like a real conversation here in terms of the code, but you can always modify that on your own. I'm going to just say my poodle and I are in Los Angeles. He likes to play tug, and I'm in that imports and user inputs list stats we have here. I want to say he likes to play tug of war and fetch. Can you help me plan a play date? Trying to anticipate what else it might ask. And let's just say he wants to play for about 3 hours. That sounds extreme. So like, it's so extreme, I can't even type it. And we'll go with what was suggested here. And you know what? We'll go with all three of these options. So for user inputs, we're passing in that my poodle and I are in Los Angeles. He likes to play tug of war and fetch. Can you help me plan a play date? We're saying he wants to play for about 3 hours. What's the weather like there today? And then great, can you suggest some fun activities? So we're really guessing what it's going to say here in advance. What I would suggest you do, however, is modify this code so that we are able to have an actual conversation where you submit input, it gives you output, you can submit, so on and so forth, so that way you're able to create those threads appropriately. But we're going to cheat the system a little bit right now. I'm going to run this again, and let's see what happens, because I really wanted to invoke one of those tools from the lovely, fabulous server that we created. So it passed in my initial prompt, and after it's done that, yes, we have a tool call. We're getting the weather right here where it says tools. Let me scroll this up for you. You can see that we have a tool call that occurred. So we are able to use our locally running server with our agent file that uses the Microsoft agent framework. And we're doing some tool calls as well. We're getting responses from the agent. This is exactly what I wanted to show you. So at this stage, you are free to move forward with continuing to iterate on the agent code that was output from the agent builder within the AI toolkit. And I do recommend using Copilot to help you wherever necessary with adding on to your pet planner agent.